Hi guys, you may already know the change detector ref class from Angular. It provides developers control over change detection. It has two methods that could be confusing: mark for check and detect changes. Yet we need to use them in different scenarios. Mark for check. This method marks a component as dirty or in need for a check in the next change detection run. It does not itself cause change detection to run immediately. This is useful when you are working with on-push change detection strategy, as it ensures the component will be checked in the next run whenever the data bound to its view has changed outside of Angular's context. Detect changes method, on the other hand, triggers change detection to run immediately for the current component and its children. This can be useful when you need to update the view immediately after some events or actions has occurred. But you want to avoid the global change detection lifecycle. Here is a summary. Mark for check marks path to this component's view and all its ancestors as dirty, needs checking for the next change detection cycle, but doesn't trigger the change detection itself. Detect changes triggers the change detection for this component's view and its children right away. Remember that frequent usage of detect changes might lead to performance issues, as it triggers change detection immediately. It's usually recommended to let Angular's change detection work naturally or utilize mark for check when working with on-push change detection strategy. Let's see now a case study where we can use these two methods. Here I have a component that allows me to dissect the message, so to extract substrings from it and create extracted fields. Here I will extract first test, then I can select another substring. I will get then this tooltip, and when I click on it, I will extract a second field. And as you can see, when I select here this substring, the tooltip does not look as I have expected. But when I hover over the tooltip, the view will be adjusted and displayed as expected. Let's have a look at the source code of this component. Here we have this condition, and when we are inside it, we are giving the value true to show tooltip. Then we are calling detect changes from change detector ref from Angular. Let's change this method by calling mark for check. Let's go to the browser again. So I will extract test first. Then when I select this substring, the tooltip is displayed as I have expected it. And this is a great example where the use of mark for check is more appropriate for this case than using detect changes. I hope that was helpful. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you next time.